Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University, and this is second mock test for the NTA UGC NET and SET examination teaching aptitude paper 1. And I'm very happy to see the huge responses which you have given to the mock test 1 which we conducted in the last week. And if those of you who have not given the mock test 1, they can again take up that test. They can watch that test. A link for that is given in the description. And friend, this test will also have the 50 questions like we have in actual paper. And the question comes, why should we give mock test? So the mock test is to assess your preparation for the teaching aptitude paper 1. Now if your score is good, that means your preparation is good, and if your score is low, that means you need to study a little more. And for those who are not preparing for the teaching aptitude paper, this mock test itself should be their preparation, because I am covering the 50 questions and I will be taking the 20 mock tests before examination. So I will be covering total 1000 questions, and of these 1000 questions, you can expect you should be able to answer in the examination at least 70% or 80% question based on only this mock test. So friends, the for our online resources like mock test on the website, you can visit the link in the description. And the rules are simple: pause the video when question appears on your screen, try to answer, and there are 2 marks for the correct answer. I have avoided the negative marking, and exam is of 100 marks. If your score is above 80, you are outstanding, your preparation for teaching aptitude paper is going well. If your score is above 60, then your preparation is good. All you need is keep revising. And if your score is above 40, and between 60 and 40 your score is average, you need to put little efforts. So and before I begin, I want to tell you, please subscribe to our channel Global Online University. And if you have subscribed, please suggest to your friends who are preparing for the UGC NET and SET examination. Now going on to the first question. So the first question is, the National Council of Educational Research and Training, that is NCERT, was established in. So friends, generally this paper 1 will ask the year of the establishment of the various autonomous government organization. So the correct answer for this is, it was NCERT was established in 1961. I hope you have answered this question correctly. The second question is, Navodaya schools have been established too. So here they have asked the motive or the aim of establishing the Navodaya schools. So friends, Navodaya schools are established keeping in mind the rural areas, so to provide good quality education in the rural areas. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Now moving on to the third question. As a principal, how would you behave with below average students? So friend, as you can see from the options, for below average student, you need to be generous. Generous meaning, or generous to me is, you have to give them extra attention. They may not catch up what you are saying. You don't have to get angry with that. You have to put a little extra efforts to make them understand. So that way you have to be generous. So this is the answer, that you should be a generous towards the below average students. Now moving on to the fourth question. The fourth question is, what is the most important while writing on the blackboard? So friend, good handwriting is like, it is a gift. Not everyone will have the good handwriting. Some of us will have good handwriting, but all of them cannot be a teacher. So everybody with whatever handwriting can be the teacher. So the B is ruled out here. The correct answer for this is, there should be a clarity in your writing. So whatever you are writing, whether good or bad, it should be readable to the everyone. So the correct answer for this question is, it should be clear to everyone. So the clarity in the writing is the correct answer. Now moving on to the fifth question. Education is powerful instrument of. So let us see options. A, social transformation. Yes, it is a powerful instrument instrument of the social transformation. B, personal transformation. Yes, if you are educated, there is certainly a personal transformation. Now, cultural transformation also takes place with the education. So, friends, so the correct answer for the this question is all of the above. Education is powerful instrument of the all of the above options. Now, moving on to the sixth question. Research problem is selected from the standpoint of. So, friends, if you have seen the research problem selection. So, friends, the major and most important factor is researcher's interest. Why it is major important? Because see, you may have financial support, you may have availability of relevant literature, and you may you may find it socially relevant. But friends, if there is no interest, it is impossible to do a good research. It is importance, researcher's interest is the prime, or it is the primary criteria for selecting the research problem. If say I am not interested in some topic, but everything else is available, if I do that research, after 6 months or after a year, I will get bored, and I there will not be a fruitful outcome. So the correct answer is researcher's interest. Moving on to the seventh question. How does a teacher can improve the attention of his students by introducing the interesting ways of teaching? So the correct answer for this is, I hope you have read the four options, is by introducing interesting ways of teaching through teaching aid. So this is the correct answer, by introducing the teaching aid. Now the eighth question is, curriculum is. So friends, we often come across in higher education system this word curriculum. So the curriculum refers to overall activities of an institution. So curriculums has all the syllabus, it is a detailed timetable of the particular course. So remember this thing, it is overall activities of an institution. And moving on, ninth question is, how would you make your students independent? So friends, if you have to make someone independent, you should give him a responsibility. Unless and until a responsibility is inferred on the individual, he won't become responsible. So the correct answer for this, to make student independent, one should give them responsibility to everyone. So everyone here refers to the students. So moving on to the next question. 10th question is, the internal communication within the institution is done through. So friends, it is done through LAN, that is local area network. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the 11th question. WWW stands for. So friends, it is an easy question, but it is good to revise because it stands for World Wide Web. That is option C. Now moving on to the 12th question. A gigabyte is equal to, so friends, GB, gigabyte, that is GB. 1 GB is equal to, we all use mobile and there is a data. So 1 GB is equal to 1024 megabyte. So friends, I hope you have followed it. And 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte. And 1024 bytes is equal to 1 kilobyte. So remember this convergence and remember this memory unit, because generally from communication, or say from ICT, information and communication technology, there are questions on memory size and memory relation. So you have to remember this. Moving on to the 13th question. A computer virus is. So friends, computer virus is a malicious software designed to infect your computer or infect some of your computer programs. So they are software. Remember this, computer virus is not a bacteria, hardware or anything else. It is a software designed to infect your computer. Now moving on to the next question, which is, the file extension of MS Word document in Office 2007 is. So friends, remember this file extension, because there will be a sure shot question on the different file extension, popular file extension. And for the extension for MS Word document in Office 2007 is .docx. So friends, remember this, the document in Office 2007, the file extension is .docx. Now moving on to the 15th question, which of the following operating system used on mobile? So friend, we know iOS system is used for Apple mobile, so that option is not here. Now generally in India, apart from Apple, what operating system is used in our mobile is Android operating system. So Windows XP and Windows Vista are used for the laptops. So remember this, the correct answer for operating system on mobile is Android. Moving on to the next question, which of the following is different from the other member? So they have asked you to take out the odd member. Now friend, if you see Windows, Linux and Mac, so these are operating system. So whereas option A, Google, which is a search engine. So remember this, Google is a search engine, Windows, Linux and Mac are operating system. So the odd members here is Google. Now moving on to the 17th question, computers on and internet are identified by. So friends, they are not identified by email. Email is for individual, so you can open in one email in other any laptop or any desktop or any mobile, but the IP address for computer is a unique ID. So their address or they are identified by IP address. Now moving on to the 18th question, CD-ROM stands for. So this is a factual question and the answer for this is compact disc read only memory. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the 19th question, it is GIF, JPG, BMP, PNG are the extension for file. So friends, these are the extension. GIF you should know, JPG and PNG, these are the extension for image data. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, that is RTE Act, Right to Education Act. So this is an important question, was implemented in India with effect from. So it was implemented in India from the 1st May 2010. So this according to this act, the government has made the primary education mandatory in India. So this was implemented, or this has come, this act has come in effect from the 1st May 2010. Now moving to the 21st question, primary education helps in. So the what are the outcome of primary education? So I will see all the options. Socialization of child, yes it happens. Democratization of child, it happens in course of understanding. So it also helps in understanding. Now so the correct answer as usual is all of the above. The primary education helps all the three options which are given. Now moving on to the 22nd questions, a child may have hearing impairment if he speaks loudly unusually. So friends, generally those who are hearing impaired, they generally talk in the louder voice. He comes nearer to the speaker during conversation. So this is also one of the symptoms or the one of the characteristic. He generally says please repeat to the teacher. So this is also one thing. And now so the correct answer is all of the above, to find out the hearing impairment in the child. Now moving on to the 23rd question, a good teacher is one who. So friends, for being a good teacher, she should inspire students to learn. So the correct answer for correct characteristic for the teacher is she should inspire students to learn. So this is the characteristic of the good teacher. Now moving on to the next question, teachers uses visual ads to make learning. So friends, teacher uses visual ads. So obviously it is it will make it simple, but if you have audio visual ads, so what happens, it becomes interesting. So so the correct answer for this is it becomes interesting. Now moving on to the 25th question, what is the most effective way to reform the aggressive behavior of child? So the options I will read and then after that we can come to the answer. He should be punished severely. So as I told, in teaching aptitude, as a teacher you cannot be a harsh, you cannot take the last approach or the last available option to you, that is harsh punishment. And B, he should be ignored. So this also cannot be done. As a teacher you should reform your student, you should be kept in isolation. So this will not solve the problem. So reason for the behavior should be investigated. So this is the correct answer. The reason for this behavior should be investigated. Now moving on to the next question. So next question is, what are the factors related to learner that affect the learning? So friends, the factors affecting the learning are, so we will read, a physical mental health of the learner, so this is obviously one factor, level of aspiration and achievement, motivation, this is also an option, readiness and willpower. So friends, all of these are the options which affect the learning. So the correct answer is all of these. Now moving on to the 27th question. The education provided to the child by the school is, so friends, the school education is a formal education, so it comes under the formal education. Read about the formal, informal and traditional education. One question like it comes every time in the examination. Moving on to the 28th question. The best method of checking students' homework is, so the best method of teaching checking students' homework is to check by teacher himself in regular way, because the student they themselves will not be able to assess the homework, so it is better to check by teacher himself in a regular way. So this is the answer. Now moving on to the 29th question. Dash dash is the considered a sign of motivated teaching. So the options are maximum attendance in the class, remedial work given by the teacher, questioning by the student. So this is the correct answer, friends. So questioning by the student is considered as a motivated teaching. Now moving on to the 30th question. Narmada Bachao Andolan is an example of, so friends, you if Narmada Bachao Andolan comes or you heard it, it is about the social worker Medha Patkar. So generally it will come to your mind that it is about women's movement. So it is not women's movement, it is about environment. So so the correct answer for Narmada Bachao Andolan is, it is an environmental movement. So remember this, it is an environmental movement. Now moving on to the 31st question. It is, parent should play a dash dash role in the learning process of young children. So options is negative, so it is ruled out, because see, no parent will play negative role in the learning process. Option C is sympathetic, so that also won't work. Sympathetic role will also not help to overall growth of the child, and neutral way also will not help. So here the correct answer is proactive. They should be proactive in the learning process of their young children. Now moving on to the 32nd question, which is, Kritika, who does not talk much at home, talks lot at school. It shows that, now option A is, they have given us one statement. Now the we have to draw some conclusion. The school provides opportunity to children to talk a lot, so that cannot be an option. Teachers demand that children should talk a lot at school, so this also cannot be an option. She does not like her home at all, so that cannot be the answer. Now her thoughts are acknowledged at school, so friend, this is the answer, because whenever you are you get acknowledged, you will speak up, and if you are suppressed, you will not talk very often, because you will be made fun of, then nobody would like to talk. Now the correct answer is, her thoughts gets acknowledged at school. So friend, 33rd question is, World Environment Day celebrated on. So this is from People and Environment. This question is from People and Environment section. And so friend, we should know the important day for at least one or say 2 days from every 10 topics of this syllabus. So at least we should know at least 30 to 40 days related to the topics from the environment or from the syllabus. So the correct answer for the World Environment Day is 5th June. On 5th June, the World Environmental Day is celebrated. And the next question is, a part of large quantity of fly ash produced in the thermal power plant is used for. Option A is soil conditioner, B making bricks, C road making, D burning. So friends, as you know that A soil conditioner also it is been used, and road making also it is been used, and D burning also it is been used, but the part of a major part is been used for the making bricks. So our option is making bricks. So moving on, which of the following gases is largely responsible for global warming? Option A is sulfur dioxide, option B is carbon dioxide, option C is chlorine, option D is ammonia. So friends, if you have read about the greenhouse gases which are responsible for global warming, so they are ozone, water vapor, methane and carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide is the main component, and option A, sulfur dioxide, C, chlorine and ammonia are not the major contributor to the global warming. So you please read the greenhouse gases, you will understand that. So option here is B, carbon dioxide, which is a major greenhouse gas. So friends, moving on to our next question, which of the following is not non-conventional energy source? Option A is solar, option B is tidal, option C is geothermal, option D is coal. So friends, the non-conventional energy sources, you can easily answer this question, that as we know that solar, wind that is tidal, wind, tidal, geothermal are the non-conventional energy sources, and the conventional energy sources is coal, petroleum and other type of thing. So this atomic things are non-conventional sources. So option here is D, coal. Next question, the selection of teaching aid depends largely on the age of student. Obviously it is it depends on the age of student, interest of student. Yes, it also depends on the interest of student, and age and motivation of the student. Yes, it depends on the age and motivation of the student. And option D is educational level and age of the student. So friends, here this selection of teaching aid, it depends on educational level and age of the student. Why? Because see, age of the student is same, it is given in the three options A, C, D, but the education level also is important. If you are using the same ad which you are using for the class 1 and the class 12, so that won't help. So in this case you have to use, see, motivation of the student, like there is no relation with teaching ad for that. So the option D, educational level and age of the student, is the correct here. Now moving on to our next question, friends. The question is, the main objective of teaching is to facilitate learning. Option A, B. Option B is to give information about unknown facts. Option C is to use teaching aid to simplify content. Option D is to form good learning habits in students. So friends, the main objective of teaching, like if you see all the options, you feel ki okay, all options can be the option, but we have to use the most probable and most possible answers. So to give information about unknown facts, see, these things, this cannot be the objective of the teaching. So option B ruled out here. C, to use teaching aids to simplify the content. Yeah, this is good, but this cannot be the objective of the teaching. See, teaching aids helps in teaching, but that should not be the objective. Now we have come across option A and D. So to form good learning habits in student, yeah, that also is an objective, but to facilitate learning, to make learning easier for the student, should be the teaching main objective of the teaching. So the answer here is to facilitate learning. So friends, these were our 5 MCQs for today. I will be uploading more such episode based on your response. Please like. So the first question is, the dash dash of research article is placed near its beginning. So friends, options are A, summary, B, abstract, C, synopsis, D, preface. So friends, here you see they have asked us what is at the beginning of the research article. So friends, here if you see option A, B, C, D, the option D is eliminated, because preface is written at the beginning of the book, not a research article. So you eliminate the option B. Now coming to the option C, synopsis. So synopsis is not something you write in the research article. It is a short or brief summary which you write of the article or of the works. So it is not part of article. Okay, now these two things, A and B, these two are the part of the articles. So friends, the article start with the abstract, then introduction, then result and discussion, and finally it ends with a summary, acknowledgement and references. So friends, this is the order: abstract, introduction, result and discussion, then summary, acknowledgement and references. So option here is abstract B. So friends, I hope you have understood this. Now next question: research journal with a high dash dash are commonly considered to be more important than those with lower ones. Now the four options here are: the eigenfactor, H index, impact factor, ITN score. So friends, now if you look at four options, you will understand what is it. Now I'll tell you, the H index, option B, and ITN score are not about the impact of the journal, research journals. They are about the individual scientist, or about, as you know, ITN is it is used for Google Scholar, and H index is a citation index for a scientist. So these two have ruled out. Now we have competition between A, eigen factor, and C, impact factor. So friend, these two are very similar to each other, but the only difference is in eigen factor, it changes when the size of journal changes. Like if you have more article, it will be different for smaller journals, and it will be different for the bigger journals. So the perfect match for this should be the impact factor. Impact factor, it is based on the citation of the journal. So citation is the criteria. If impact factor is high, the journal is considered more like it is a valuable journal. Impact factor is less, it is not that good journal. Now moving on to our so the answer here is C, impact factor. Friends, have idea of all these terms. Now the next question: A dash dash is a short term intensive course for small group, emphasizing problem solving and learning newer technique. So friends, option A is workshop, B is seminar, C is summer school, and D is refresher course. So friends, refresher schools and summer schools, summer school are eliminated here, because summer school is only for summer vacation, and it is not meant for the newer technique or problem solving, this thing, emphasis on problem solving. And refreshers course also eliminated. Now we have A, workshop, and B, seminar. So seminar is, it the above statement suits to seminar, but seminar is used in broader terms, like it has other activities also. If you see the workshop, it is a part of seminar only, but it is specific to the problem solving and learning newer techniques. So option here is A, workshop. Now moving to the next question of ours here: what is Prasar Bharati? Now this is related to communication thing. It is a private company owning TV channels, a telecom company owning a large mobile network, and advertising and public relation wing of central government, an autonomous body for public radio and TV broadcasting. So as we know that Prasar Bharati is somewhere related to government of India, but it is not a private company. So option A is eliminated. And telecom company owning a large mobile network, no, it is not. It is it is not a telecom company, so it is a broadcaster only. So option C and D we have here. So it is advertising and public relation wing of central government. No, this is not the option. So it is, the option here is the autonomous body of public radio and TV broadcasting. So D is the option. Remember this thing, friends. Now the next question: the HTTP, the full form in the context of internet. They have asked us what is the full form of HTTP. Friends, please remember a full form of HTTP: www. So this World Wide Web is the full form of www. So HTTP is four options: higher text transmission process, higher technical textual platform, hyper text transfer protocol, and hyper transmission of truncated procedure. So option, as I have written here, is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Please remember I told you www world wide web and http. So this is it, friends. So the question is, which of the following is the correct chronology of internet based facilities? So they have given option A, Google, Hotmail, Facebook and WhatsApp. So friends, you should know that, because see, in teaching this Google, Hotmail and Facebook and WhatsApp, now these social media and search engines have become very popular for any knowledge giving or whatever. So the friends know that when Google was founded, Google was founded in 1998 by Sergey Brin and co-founder. Hotmail was founded in 1996 by Indian origin Sabir Bhatia, and Facebook was founded, somewhere around 2005, I believe, I don't remember the exact, but and WhatsApp was founded in 2009. So friends, from this information you can easily say the option C, that as Hotmail 1996, Google 1998, Facebook 2005 or 4, I don't remember that, and the WhatsApp was founded at 2009. So the option here is option C. So friends, moving on to the next question, identify the odd element from the following on the basis of its basic function. So friends, here if you see Windows, Android, MS Office, Linux and Unix,